The Evergreen Wood by Alan and Linda Parry. Chapter 7. The Evergreen Wood.
The Evergreen Wood. I think they're
there. The Evergreen.
Act 1. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 5 and 6. Get wisdom, get understanding. Do not forget nor turn away from the words of my mouth. Do not forsake her, for she will preserve you, her love, and she will keep you. Christopher and Heathley did not stop running until they reached the safety of the pathway on the other side of the steps.
I shall leave a notice on the steps to prevent others from following that way. Over these steps, the way looks fair, but dear travelers, please take care, for evil and dark despair lurk within the fox's lair.
Many creatures did read the notice and so escaped that terrible danger. The pathway led the mice into an ancient cedar grove. The great trees spread their massive limbs out over the grove, as if tender sympathy for the creatures that walked beneath them. A flock of turtle doves had made its home among the thick green foliage. One of them flew down and spoke to Christopher and Heathley.
Good day. Welcome to the Cedar Grove.
Good day. I wonder whether you could tell us how far it is to the Evergreen Wood.
Too far for any but those that shall reach it.
Is the way safe or dangerous?
Safe for those for whom it is to be safe.
She flew up onto a wide, drooping branch.
If you would like to climb up here, you may see the very gates of that wood.
Christopher and Heathley scrambled up onto the broad bog and peered into the distance. Christopher's eyes grew wide.
Can you see them?
I think I can.
Heathley peered through the trees. Before they left the cedar grove, the turtle dove presented them with directions of the way.
Beware of false friends, and take care that you do not sleep upon the enchanted ground.
Then she flew away, and Heathley tucked the map in his inside pocket. And so, much encouraged, the two creatures set off, hoping that it would not be long before they reached the gateway that would lead them into the Evergreen Wood. Okay, that's the end of Act 1. Now for the question time. What was the verse? Jackson.
Proverbs 4, 5 through 6.
I think I got a monkey, a spider monkey hand. I got that. Okay.
Proverbs chapter 4, verse 5 and 6. Get wisdom. Get understanding. Do not forget nor turn away from the words of my mouth. Do not forsake her, and she will preserve you. Love her, and she will keep you. Where had they escaped from? Abigail, the fox's lair. Oh, yeah, the fox was all ready to have an evening dinner, but he took a little siesta first. And his dinner walked away.
It ran away.
It ducked away. Why did they leave a message? Christy!
To get spotted?
No, they didn't. It's not that they didn't want to get spotted. Why did they leave a message? Clara!
Because they didn't want them to, the fox to, they didn't want them to go into the fox's lair.
Who?
The people that saw the steps.
Well, that was wrong.
No, that's fine. She's the people that saw the steps. The animals that saw the steps would read it and say, "Oh, we don't want to go that way." Okay, did it help? Did it help?
I don't.
Bethany.
Yes.
Yes, it did. Living in the tree. What was living in the tree? Elijah. A bird. Turtle doves. Were they friend or foe? Were they friend or foe? Jane. They're friends.
Those are nice.
Yeah.
Turtles are weird.
Turtle, weird.
Now, it's interesting how if you listen to what the turtle doves said, you had to really listen to them. They said, too far for any but those who shall reach it. That sounds a little puzzling.
Yeah.
But what it's referring to is that if you're really a believer, if you're really a follower of Christ, you will make it. But ones that are false followers will wander off and will never make it. So if you really care, there's no limit. You will make it. Nothing would make you want to give up. What did they warn Christopher about? What did they warn Christopher and Heathley about? Bella?
False friends? Sleeping on the enchanted grave?
All right, she got them both. She got them both. Sleep upon the enchanted ground. You know, there's a lot of people out there that want to be your friend, but you gotta listen. Though they might be your friends, you gotta listen how they talk to you. They can lead you astray. So that's why we always gotta go back to the Bible and says, well, you know, he's my friend, she's my friend, but what they're doing isn't what the Bible says. So we got to be careful for that. Okay. All right, we're going to get ready for
Act 2.
Proverbs chapter 14, verse 5. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 5. I wonder why I repeated that. A faithful witness does not lie, but a false witness will utter lies. Previously, Christopher and Heathley had just left the Turtle Doves after being given wisdom. Soon after, a little crooked lane met the pathway. And wandering along it, looking this way and that, came Shady, the water shrew.
Where did you come from?
I live in the marsh at the bottom of the little crooked lane, but I'm on my way to the evergreen wood.
Now how are you going to get in without a key?
Shady thought for a moment.
Oh, I expect I shall find a way.
He broke off every now and then to take a dip in the ditch that was by the wayside. So Christopher and Heathley soon overtook him. Presently, the pathway divided, and as they paused to consider which way to go, a gray rabbit came hopping towards them.
Follow me. This is the way.
They followed the gray rabbit for some time.
It's white.
Then suddenly the ground beneath their feet gave away and they found themselves falling. Down, down they fell until at last they came to the bottom of an enormous rabbit hole. Christopher hit with a thump. Came tumbling down beside him.
Oof. We should have paid more attention to the turtle dove. She warned us to beware of false friends.
And we forgot to read the map she gave us.
They laid there, sad and lonely, at the bottom of the hole for some time. Eventually, the sound of tiny feet could be heard far above them.
Christopher, Heathley.
That's right.
No, actually, I know who that
is. A pale, anxious face appeared down.
It's the white mouse!
Christopher jumped up and down in excitement.
Oh, white mouse, how pleased I am to see you.
The white mouse, in anticipation of such a problem, had brought with him a long rope. He had wrapped one end around a tall ash tree. The other end he lowered over the edge of the deep hole.
Catch a hold of the rope and pull yourselves up.
When they were once again standing on firm ground, Christopher hugged the white mouse.
Thank you for rescuing us.
And we're sorry for causing you so much trouble.
You would cause me a lot less trouble if you would only follow your instructions. Now, let me guide you back to the pathway.
The sorry pair struggled behind with their heads bowed to the ground. When they reached the pathway, the sun had already gone down, and the mouse made a bed of dry leaves under the roots of a wide beech tree.
We'll rest here for the night.
Heathley gathered some of the beech nuts that laid all about, and they sat cracking the shells in the moonlight and nibbling on the little seeds inside.
Over. All right. That's we're going to have more than two acts in this one here.
That was not the white mouse. That was Mr. Ten.
Shh.
script, so I don't know what I'm going to read.
Or a phone. You didn't have a phone either.
Okay.
Or she had a belt.
What was the animal that showed up to him first?
I know.
Christy.
The gray bunny.
What color was the gray bunny?
It's the gray.
Insects hummed and droned lazily about them. The rat yawned.
Let us lie down and take a nap. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
Oh no! If we fall asleep here, we may never wake up again. For we are walking upon the enchanted ground.
Oh dear. If I had been here alone, I would have been in great danger.
Well, two are better than one.
And he sang a song to keep them awake.
Be alert, stay awake, keep on going, don't hesitate. On this ground enchantments lie, slumbering valleys heave and sigh, calling creatures to the deep, unfathomed depths of silent sleep.
Having safely passed over the enchanted ground, they rested for a while beside a lily pond. Here they met the little water shrew again, basking in the sunny waters. The three went on together until they came within sight of the gateway. But as they drew nearer, they saw to their dismay that a very deep and wide river lay between them and the gateway. They looked for a bridge to go over, but there was none.
We shall have to swim across.
Do you think we shall make it?
If we do not panic, we should manage quite easily.
Christopher entered the water with some trepidation. He and Heathley swam side by side. All went well at first, but towards midstream, the current became stronger, and Christopher grew anxious.
Oh, Heathley, I shall be swept away!
What?
I found out what?
Keep going, Christopher! We have almost reached the other side.
But Christopher was in despair.
I don't think I can make it.
He sputtered as the wave washed over his ear.
I'm thirsty.
Meanwhile, Shady had been nosing about in the water. Lie down.
You can make it. You can.
And had discovered an old flat-bottomed boat. Shady loved boats. He leaped onto it, pulled it free of the reeds, and glided off down the river. Christopher and Heathley saw him go. Shady seemed to have forgotten all about them and the evergreen wood. Heathley stretched out his paw and held his friend's head above water until they reached the bank on the other side.
That's the way.
The
wall.
There's
the gate.
Christopher took out the key out of his inside coat pocket and turned the lock.
Skip the part.
The gate swung open. Bright lights beamed down upon them, and the glow through the tall green trees, the stream of living water sparkled wide and fresh through the woods. A golden flower grew alongside the bank. A great company of animals stood waiting to greet them. They cried.
Welcome to the Evergreen Wood, and well done, you faithful creatures. Come and share our happiness.
They crowded around the heroes, each wanting to greet them with a brotherly kiss. Their own white mouse was there too.
Come, we have prepared a feast for you. I have some good news, too. Woodley has been released, and is on his way.
Hooray!
Hooray!
And the knight will be arriving soon with Christina and the children.
My happiness is almost complete!
Yay! The end!